This bulging folder is absolutely rammed with ideas that have been proposed for Manlab, but that have never made it onto the screen. Why not? Well, some of them, frankly, are rubbish, like the dog training challenge or build your own Viking longship. But a lot of them are great. They're simply not very suitable for television. They're too long-winded or they're not very visual, as our director would say. But it does seem a pity to waste them. So then we had another idea that won't make it onto the television. We'll do them on the radio. Why are we really doing this? It's because, despite the proliferation of newspapers and magazines and radio stations and TV channels, there are still people who don't have a voice. And with Radio Manlab 107.0 FM, we are giving them a forum, a place where they can speak freely about art and science and natural history and love and personal problems and metalwork, free of any sort of populist or commercial considerations. And there are, of course, people who won't like this. And that's why we're broadcasting from a place where no one can touch us. Offshore. So here we go, in the spirit of the great pirate radio pioneers, Caroline, obviously, we are broadcasting from a longboat, Elizabeth of Glamis, on the Grand Union Canal in all its beauty, just outside Milton Keynes in Bedfordshire. We've never done this before. Here we go. Cast off.
Now, if you're too young to know what one of these is, let alone one of these, pirate radio was popular in the 60s thanks to offshore radio ships like Caroline. Because they were technically in international waters, they could broadcast unlicensed anarchy and give listeners something they'd never had before, challenging the orthodoxy and giving the people a voice. We're going to be doing exactly the same and with the latest technology.
Is that being broadcast?
So, at Radio Manlab, everything works through 3G. At the back of the boat is this box, which contains 6 mobile phone SIM cards. We simply transmit on whichever SIM card has the best signal at any time. That signal then whizzes back to a secret local rooftop, where it's converted to FM and blasted out of these antennas to enthrall the whole of Milton Keynes.
Radio Manlab 107 FM, just cast off here on the Grand Union Canal and heading for our first lock gate. Good morning, everybody. Coming up later on the show, we've got Peter, the Mingy Kamumba's coracle man, in the water giving us live reports of action as it happens here on the Grand Union Canal.
There's just one small hitch in our mission to inform, educate and anarchise. While the BBC obviously loved to promote the kind of illegal radio activity that stuffed them in the 60s, they've told us we have to get a licence or they'll replace us with MasterChef. We may now be the most regulated anarchist pirates in radio history, but we can still be the people's station.
Manlab 107 FM.
We've bludgeoned the Biebers, garrotted the Gagas, and instead of generic auto-tuned pop, we have guests that would otherwise never see the light of day.
Joining me off the riverbank, finally, and on the boat is Peter Mingy Kamumbus, our coracle builder from the previous series of Manlab. Peter, hello.
Good morning, James.
One of humanskind's most primitive watercraft, I suppose. I mean, after the cut-out log and so on, it's the coracle, isn't it?
Yeah, well, the curras, the sea boats, were used by the Mesolithic people 8,000 years ago, so I think the coracle could be even beyond the last ice age, we don't know, but very, very ancient form of transport.
And what are you going to do for us today? You've brought your trusty coracle along, the one that we've seen before, and you're going to paddle up and down the river, and what are you going to report on?
I'm looking for interesting flora and fauna.
OK, you go off, if you don't mind, and get in your coracle, and we'll fade up CD player 2. I've no idea what's on it.
This is what Manlab FM is all about. Here is a man who spends his time wandering around the forest, alone and in tiny shorts, picking up sticks to make Neolithic boats. He's never had anyone to talk to, but now, thanks to our semi-pirate radio station, he has.
Anyway, Dan, I'd love to go over to Peter Mingy Kamumbus. Who is... I can see he's behind us. He's trailing a bit, to be honest.
How do we get him up on our airwaves, Dan?
We can talk to him whenever we like.
OK,
apparently.
Let's see if we can work out the slider. Just in case you've only just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, we've never done this before, and Dan is making a face at me to say, no, it's not possible. We can't get Peter Mingy Kamumbus up on the mic.
It may not look it, but this could be a very expensive problem.
So is he out of range of the radio, Mark?
He's out of range. I've got B-cam on him right now.
Because we're now being regulated by broadcasting law, any radio silence or dead air can land us a fine from Ofcom of up to £25,000 per minute.
Which radio mic is he on?
Peter, now broadcasting to no one, is making the most expensive cosy riverside nature report in radio history.
There's some wild angelica there. That's the stuff they put on tops of cakes, angelica.
So we can't speak to him?
Not yet.
Anyway, on line one, I believe we have Jane, who is here to play Radio Battleships. Hello, Jane. Are you there?
Good afternoon, James. Yes, I am.
Excellent. Fantastic. You should have a 10 by 10 grid marked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J down the side. Have you got that?
Yes, I have, yes.
Right, you now need to draw some battleships on, and they are an aircraft carrier, which is 5 squares long.
Yep.
The battleship, which is 4 squares long, a destroyer and a submarine, each of which are 3 squares long.
This went on longer than the Battle of Trafalgar.
C4. Jane?
Yes, I'm here. Yes, that's a miss.
That's a miss. Oh, dear. Hang on, I'll play the sound effect.
I-3.
This is, even by Manlab FM standards, a bit of a low point.
On Radio Mike 1, I believe I am now in contact with Peter Minji Kamumbus in the Coracle on the Grand Union Canal. Are you there, Peter?
I certainly am.
Ah, fantastic.
I'm puffed, but I'm all right.
Yes, I'm sure you are.
Look what we've got here.
What?
A little baby moorhen, look.
Oh, God, I can see that, yes, just off the starboard bow.
Quack, quack. I had an amazing experience in a forest once when I was out running. There was a baby deer, just a tiny one, came running up to me and was nuzzling my knees because I think Mum might have been shot or something the night before.
Peter's unconventional and slightly disturbing nature report fills the gap before our afternoon guests. After some initial hiccups, Manlab FM is back on track, and if we can keep this going until 4, when our licence expires, we might just do this. And as the rest of our guests arrive, finally, the People's Station starts to come together.